This video is my case for why ShareTribe should be your go-to all-in-one tech stack when building a marketplace app as a non-tech founder. First, we'll establish why ShareTribe offers everything a no-code app builder should. Versatility, ease of use, cost effectiveness. Then, I'll cover two additional features that make ShareTribe better. Transitioning to custom development and open source code base, aka no vendor login. Let's just take a quick look at common types of marketplace apps. As we do that, we'll look at key features for each type together with general app features you will see across marketplaces in general. Then we transition into how ShareTribe can deliver all these features with a couple of additional USPs that I think you'll find super compelling. And if there's enough time, I'll spend a minute or so asking ShareTribe to pay me for the honor of being endorsed by Adrian Ching. Editor, can you play footage of admiring friends? Let's start. Types of marketplace apps. Founders of marketplace apps will want one of three main types. The first and most common sell physical and digital products. Think Amazon, Etsy, eBay, and Steam. Defining features include stock management, multi-vendor support, and shipping and returns. The second type primarily sells services. Think Fiverr or Uber. Defining features include location-based features and built-in invoices for B2B transactions. The last type are rental marketplaces where you book something temporarily. I think we are all thinking of the same thing here, Airbnb. Defining features, again, location-based features, trust building like photo or video identification, aka the police can identify you with this if you wreck my house, and clearly stated terms. On top of these specific features, pretty much all marketplaces will need login and authentication, user profiles, SKU listings, search bars, filters, checkout, secure online payment gateways, on-platform communication, reviews, and for the backend, admin capabilities, app analytics, and good old SEO. If these app types and features are what you need, ShareTribe can deliver. Quick introduction to ShareTribe. ShareTribe has two packages, ShareTribe Go and ShareTribe Flex. Together, they are the perfect solution for a lot of marketplace use cases. You only have to look at their user showcase to see the huge variety of apps they cater to. And for new founders just testing out an idea, ShareTribe Go is perfect. For the reasonable price of $119 per month, a ShareTribe Go subscription allows you to rapidly customize an existing template. You get a working app with all the necessary features of a marketplace. Payment gateway, analytics, listings, authentications, SEO, everything. ShareTribe offers hosting, but you're free to use your own domain. That right there is an MVP, ready to face users within a few days worth of work, exactly as an MVP should be. Quick warning, two marketplace types not supported under Go are reverse transactions and auction marketplaces. Auctions are pretty straightforward, but what's a reverse transaction? It's where service providers compete with each other to get chosen by the buyer. Say my toilet is broken, and instead of me calling a plumber, I post about it on a marketplace. Three different plumbers message me different rates. One asks for $100, the second asks for $50, and the third says he will do it for free. He just likes to smell toilet seats. That's a slightly disturbing example of a reverse transaction. Anyway, these are all marketplaces powered by basic ShareTribe templates. Link will be in the description. I strongly urge you to check it out after the video and after you subscribe to this channel. Going beyond MVP, say your marketplace is a success. First off, congratulations. Now, you want to really build it beyond the capabilities of a template. If you were on most other no-code app builders, you'd have to hire a developer and they start building your app from scratch. With ShareTribe, you still have to hire a developer, but you can easily transition into ShareTribe Flex, where ShareTribe provides a headless backend designed for marketplaces. Headless just means there's no pre-built frontend or head. The idea is that you can now get your developers to build you a custom frontend with all the features and integrations you want and easily connect it to ShareTribe's backend. If that sounds like a lot of extra steps, it just means that you're not at a stage where custom development makes sense. You have to compare apples to apples. If you're just starting out or this marketplace is just an extension of your physical shop, why go custom? As you grow and scale, to differentiate yourself from competitors, enhance the user experience, tighten security, and many more, custom development becomes necessary. And this level of customization will always cost more time and money. But it costs less money and takes less time with ShareTribe Flex. Their specialized template covers the essential, and a developer can modify, add, or remove features depending on your needs. You can then easily migrate your ShareTribe Go data to the new marketplace. Past transactions, custom fields, user profiles, and payment gateway account details. All these key data points get moved over for a seamless transition. Your users don't feel like they're moved, they just think the existing app got an upgrade. In fact, ShareTribe even lets you import external data, meaning data from outside a Flex app. But this will definitely need the help of someone with technical know-how. But it's possible. To move to a ShareTribe Flex account is going to run you $299 per month for up to $30,000 in monthly transaction value. If you're making $30,000 a month, are you really complaining about $300? Shut up and enjoy your $29,700. All this is to show that with ShareTribe, you can build just about any marketplace you want at a reasonable price. But that's not why I recommend ShareTribe. There are a few ShareTribe alternatives that lets you build marketplaces that are just as comprehensive. YoCart is great, WooCommerce is pretty good, Bubble is alright. But I'm sure there are a ton of other platforms out there. So why ShareTribe? Simple, the ability to export your app. In case ShareTribe ever does anything you don't like, you can just leave and your app goes with you. Unlike the poor users of Bubble who had to learn the hard way how invaluable it is to own your code. The lesson of Bubble. Bubble is a no-code web app builder, one of the oldest and one of the best. One of its biggest drawbacks is that you need to use its proprietary code base to build your app. For years, the no-code community just accepted it as a trade-off. Then in 2023, Bubble suddenly introduced a change in pricing strategy that sank the business model of many non-tech founders. They couldn't even move their app anywhere else because it could only work on Bubble. If for some reason ShareTribe goes with their users' money, the users are free to live together with their app's source code and data. ShareTribe automatically provides access to full backup and database export at any time. There are some parts that don't get automatically exported. User passwords, PayPal channel billing agreement IDs, security certificates SSL. I don't recommend it, but you can even manually download user password so their login details stay the same. ShareTribe has made the codebase open source and available on GitHub, so anyone can access it, customize it, and host it. That doesn't mean just anyone can actually do it. You need to know how to code. But the point is, there is no vendor login. Any developer can build you a marketplace with existing data from ShareTribe Go or Flex. This means you, as a user, do not have to put up with shenanigans from ShareTribe. That also means ShareTribe is less likely to subject you to shenanigans in the first place. They need to make their offerings more attractive than just doing it yourself. I find myself drawn to the variety of ShareTribe's showcase. You have psychic tarot readings, an aromatherapy marketplace. You have Fish My Spot, a fishing spot booking app. You have software support and on-demand marketplace for job seekers. You know it will be good enough for most marketplaces, including yours. So if you're in the market for a marketplace, give ShareTribe a look. And if you ever want a developer to build you a Flex-powered frontend, you know where to find me. Until then, I'll recommend you to check out my video on minimum livable product. There are so many marketplaces, and sometimes just being good enough isn't good enough. Users are spoiled. The concept of minimum livable product is all about getting your users to love using your app from the start. That's how you get brand loyalty. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, and leave a comment. What topics on no and low code would you like to know more about? I just realized I forgot to back ShareTribe, but at least I get to keep my dignity. Let's check out what MLP is all about.